box. Anyway, we'll go to the next one now as well. We're not messing around here. We're going to get straight into it. Game number three between Bender and Chris from the Arbalest Cup in 2003. 11-year-old game, 11-year-old strategies, 11-year-old... No, not 11-year-old players. That would be wrong. But these guys... battling it out at the moment. Chris won, Bender won, and this is game number three. Bender now down to the south of the map in the blue, playing as the Huns once again. And up to the north of the map in the yellow, we've got Chris also playing as the Huns again. I find that interesting that they would both play Huns again. I didn't think Hun Wars were that popular in 2003. They certainly weren't as popular as they are today. That is for sure. But yeah, Hun War again. But that's not a problem, you know. Hun Wars are still really fun, especially in 2003. They were a lot more fun back then than they were today. The map is... I don't know. The map is German. It says Fluss, I think. I'm not sure. It looks a little bit like... it looks a little bit like rivers to me. Can anyone translate that? I'm pretty sure it's rivers, because you've got the what's it called, the lake, the river on the outside, and you've got a river through the middle with the shallows going across. It looks like rivers, but yeah, I mean, don't boo that it's Huns again. This is good. But yeah, water element at play. The water here can be often very imbalanced, actually, because. If you have a look at the map here, Bender has got a back water, and that's not nice. Oh, sorry, for Chris, that's not nice. For Bender, that's fantastic. He could dock back here really safely. He can take the big fish that are back here, and, you know, he doesn't even have to worry too much about being attacked, because wherever Chris docks, it's going to be quite far away. But for Chris, his nearest water is on the front. His safe water, which is at the corner, is miles away from him. And, yeah, I mean, there's not really so much in this for Chris at the middle. I mean, he'd have to put a very aggressive dock down, and it's not really that beneficial to put the dock on the front as it is to put it on the back. But we will see, because if Bender decides to dock aggressively, then we could see some aggression in the early feudal age on this middle area of the map. There's quite a lot of fish over this side. The fish can be really unfair and imbalanced on these old maps as well. Well, not old maps, but the non-modified versions of these maps. Look at these fish here, having a great time. Having an absolute whale of a time in the water there, flopping around. But yeah, I mean, whoever docks there is going to have a great time, but I don't think they're going to dock there. I think Chris might dock on the front, but actually, never mind. What is Chris doing? Coming forward and, okay, he's walling it up. Anal drone, thank you very much. Stay tight, everybody. $1.25. anal drone, tightest butthole, EU. But Chris coming forwards pretty quickly here, walling this one up very, very nicely. And gonna, I don't know, leave this villager on this side? Is he gonna leave the villager over this side? He is, you know. What is he gonna do? Is he gonna build a barracks over here? I don't know. Bender going for the dock on the front. I think Bender must have scouted the good fish there. Yeah, he did. Look at that. He's scouted those fish and he's like, I'm having some of those fish, boy. Putting that dock up right there. Good location for a dock for Bender. Could have played it safe and gone for the fish at the back, but no, he's being greedy, and he's going to take the fish at the front. These massively unfair fish. Chris, on the other hand, also docking at the front as well on this little corner here. So I think we might see a little bit of early water aggression. And where did that villager from Chris go? Is she still around, or did she go back? She is looking like she. Oh, she's taking the stone. Bender's got no idea. This villager right here taking the stone. Chris might want to maybe do a tower in the feudal age or something. Just leaving this sneak villager behind here. I like it. I like it a lot. And you know what as well? Bender hasn't even found his sheep yet. You know, Chris may have found them if he scouted slightly further to the right. That would have been very good, actually. But anyway, Chris got this sneak villager. He could build a barracks, but you know, that would delay the fishing ships coming out at the front, so I think he'll just leave her back here and try and keep her hidden for now. Back at home, taking in that second boar, of course. Same for Bender. They're pretty much even, I think. I think these guys are really close in the early game, actually. Bender taking that boar a little bit soon, though, actually, which is surprisingly. Happy Camel Licker. So tight, it could pop a wine bottle. My God, why would you be putting a wine bottle? You know what? I don't know. I don't want to know even what you get up to in your spare time. If it involves wine bottles and anuses, yeah, count me out, please. Count me out. anyway, this scout from Bender actually walked past Chris's villager there, but he didn't notice. So Chris gonna... Oh, no. He's gonna go back. Maybe he got a hunch that there was something there. It's in sight, and the game is up. Chris has been found. Bender sending his villager over. Is he gonna try and wall this villager in? I think he might, you know. I think that he's going to try and wall it in, because Chris, his villager, doesn't have the same line of sight that Bender's scout does. So Bender coming in with the scout now, and the wall... Oh, no. Okay, never mind. He's not going to wall it, but he is going to attack it, and that's not going to work out for Chris. That villager will get taken down. The wolf is coming in as well. He's attracted the attention of Gaia. Remember the 5th of November, indeed. Hopefully you guys can't hear too many fireworks in the background there. Thank you very much, dude, for the donation. I really appreciate it. I appreciate all of you guys just for tuning in and just being awesome all the time. It's great. And Chris, trying to save the day, trying to wall his villager in. No, he's not going to do it. What is he doing? If he clutches this, that would be insane. Oh my God, he did. He clutched it. I can't believe that. But oh, he deleted the wall. His villager's getting away, though. Oh, my God. Wow. He actually caught the wolf in there. That was incredible. But it didn't work out in the end. His scout went down. His villager went down. The game is up for Chris. That was unfortunate. That could have been fantastic. He so nearly clutched that villager. That would have been insane. I don't know how he pulled that off. But, yeah. Bender catching him out. Catching him with his pants down. Catching him red-handed and safely fishing these huge piles of fish on the front. More fishing ships than Chris at this point in time. Chris also taking the shore fish. So, not great for Chris at this point in time. He's a villager down as well, but he is up to the feudal age a little bit faster. Bender on 69, 70% now. Chris, though, galley is coming out at the front, and he's going to look to try and take those docks, those ships down as fast as he can. Bender here, dock visible through the fog for Chris, and that third dock now going up on the front. So they've both walled it up. It is going to be both of them fighting for the water. And I've got to apologize. I'm stumbling over my words so much tonight. It's like I know what I want to say, but it's just not coming out. That's not good, is it? Anyway, galleys, and Chris going to be the first one to pop them galleys out, which is good. Because he needs that little advantage to start pulling this game back to his favor, I think. Bender so far, 31 pop. Chris on 28. Bender with an extra fishing ship, though. And also Chris being a villager down. So Chris's eco not in a great place compared to Bender at the moment. And Bender's just got to try and keep these ships alive. Because these are going to actually pull his game really high up in terms of eco. Because... The big fish are just... They make or break games. They really do. Bender, though, a bit slow getting the galleys out. The first one coming out now. The second one coming out as well. And now they're 2-2. Bender with that third dock coming up as well. And that's something... This is something you never see. Look at that. Chris putting a tower now between these three docks. When do you ever see that? If you kind of see that in games these days, you just assume that the player is some kind of mega noob or something. But no, Chris taking the precaution, putting up the watchtower, and I guess it kind of makes sense in a way as well, because Chris will be able to retreat his fishing ships back here. The tower will kill off any enemy galleys very quickly, which is fantastic. So that watchtower's going up, and it's going to cost Chris a bit of stone, perhaps unnecessarily, because if he wins the water, it's not even going to come into play, and he is winning the water at this point in time. So there you go. But yeah, that tower going up. The reason why I think it's unnecessary is because if he does get up a up to the castle age, you will be able to TC. X05, Ken Shin became a Wallalo Warlord. Thank you very much, man. Welcome to the club. Lots of extra benefits for you, and of course, becoming a Warlord is like, you know, it's the equivalent of being or gaining a knighthood. I should like knight every Warlord who decides to join the Warlords. Thank you very much, man. You are awesome. And like I was saying, yeah, this tower probably not going to have much impact here because Chris is already winning the water and it's cost him 125 stone. So when he gets up to the castle age, it means it's going to be a little bit more awkward for him to get that second and third TC out, which is never, ever a good thing at all. Bender, though, looks like he's going to run in here for the fishing ships. The tower actually having an impact now, starting to do good damage to these galleys, but Chris losing a ship anyway. It looks like Bender's going to try and focus them down here. Those fishing ships getting taken down ever so surely as Bender rushes them. Chris going to lose 1, 2, and 3. I think he's going to lose them all. Even fighting under this tower, he's going to lose them all. And Bender, I think at this point, knows he's probably lost the water. So he suicides his galleys, takes out Chris's fishing ships, removes that advantage from Chris at this point. And Chris, again, going to do the same to Bender. He's going to take out Bender's ships as well. But I think Bender got much more from the water than Chris did so far. He definitely got a lot more food from his fishing ships. He definitely got more value from them because he was taking the big fish rather than the shore fish. And now that Chris has the water control, he's not got any fishing ships to protect anyway. So for now, water control not too vital, but Chris coming out with a transport ship, and that's on the way up at the moment. We'll see what he does. It looks like to me he'll transport some villagers across. I like that a lot because he can build his forward over here, which is something that water control will give him the opportunity to transport across safely. But in the early feudal age, I don't think water control is so important on this map. It's going to be important later on when it comes to defending this choke point and preventing units from crossing over. But if Chris does this landing anyway, it might not be too crucial, actually, because... the water might not even come into play because this landing could be the end for Bender if it goes well. So Chris taking a good opportunity to do the landing now. And Bender still actually making some galleys at the moment. He's not giving up on the galleys. He's just doing his blacksmith now. So he's going to go for +1 attack. And, blacksmith at all from Chris at the moment. So Chris still holding water control, but Bender trying to get it back. And I think I may just have heard... Oh, no, that was just more... Yeah, it was a dock. He's just put another dock up on this right-hand side. So Bender not going to give up, but he as well is building a transport ship. This is almost like watching a Highland game right now. In fact, Rivers and Highland played fairly similarly. Chris going to do a landing with his ship. Bender going to do a landing with his, building this dock way out of the way. Will Chris see it, though? I mean, he has got a galley over here. It could just happen that Bender will run into this galley. So Bender... gonna bring the villagers over, gonna transport ships and villagers across, and that's gonna be fantastic. He's deleting the dock as well. He's getting super sneak mode. Very sneaky. Sneaky beaky like. And Chris is bringing the galley across. Has he seen it? No, he's not. Oh my god, that was really close. And Bender gonna send that transport across now. Sneaky beaky like. And Chris doing the same, sending his transport across, and these guys are literally just so close, they don't even know it. Chris deleting his transport as well. They both think they're being so sneaky, and neither of them know that they're being landed by the other. Both of them deleting their dock and, like, deleting the transport ship. I love it. Bender deleting his transport ship as well. They're like the SAS force. They're like the black ops of the medieval ages, going across, deleting their only means of escape. These brave men and women of the medieval ages. Fantastic stuff. Chris, forward archery range. Archer's coming out. Bender, on the other hand, not putting up anything just yet, but he can afford it. Barracks going up for him. Chris made the barracks back at home, which is usually the most common thing to see. But that second range now going up as well for Chris. And Bender completely undefended, and he's actually going up to the castle age now as well. Chris still feudal. We know what Chris is like. He loves to play feudal aggression. And actually walling up this left flank. He's actually worried that he might be landed here. And he doesn't know that Bender's on this right side, stable coming up, and Bender's going to stop production as soon as he gets up to the castle age. Chris, meanwhile, fletching done. Archers coming out. The question is, how many archers will he make before he attacks? Now, ideally, the longer you leave it for, the better. Well, it's not the longer, but like, if Chris attacks now with three archers, that'll give Bender enough time to defend, because he'll be able to get a range up, start making some, he'll be able to get a range up and start making some skirmishers, and Chris is actually going for it. I think that's a mistake. I think it would make more sense for Chris to get five or six archers first and then attack. Wait until he can at least one-shot villagers before attacking. So there's Bender's villagers running to the TC. Might have been worth suiciding a villager to block this off, though, actually, because Chris has got a very easy path into Bender's base, but Bender needs two palisades to block it off. Might have been worth suiciding a villager for that. But Chris getting into this wood line. Bender now, what's he got wood-wise? He's not got enough wood. He's going to fight these archers with his villagers, fighting like a man back here, as that castle age upgrade is about 90% complete. He has to kill these villagers in the woodline, otherwise he can't afford, which is the big one, he can't afford to make an archery range. In fact, he just dropping off a little bit of wood now, can finally put an archery range back at home. He'd probably go for a knight though, actually, a stable rather than a range. And this is what I was saying about Chris delaying his attack now. There's the stable at the back. If Chris delays his attack and actually has more archers, there's no way Bender would have been able to fight that with his villagers there. That would have just been suicide. But because Chris has waited, he's not been patient, these archers actually aren't doing as much damage as they could do. And Bender's just surrounding them with his villagers and killing them off one by one. Even though they have plus one defense and plus one attack, they're getting taken down. And Bender losing, what, three or four villagers so far? It's not too bad at the moment, and there will be a knight on the way out any second now as well, just to finish this off. But Chris coming forwards with a watchtower, not letting up, and meanwhile, Bender getting his just desserts back at Chris's base, taking out two villagers of his own, taking out some more in the woodline, and if Bender kills another two villagers, they're going to be completely even in terms of villagers lost. The difference here, though, is that Chris has got nothing at the moment to defend, starting that spearman production now. And no reason at all to be scared of spearmen. Chris going to let those villagers go back to the woodline, back to their deaths, more like, as Bender's knights patrolling there. Now, spears are not a problem. If Bender just attacks the spears now, he's going to be absolutely fine. They're going to do nearly, next to nothing to these knights. Now they have bloodlines and plus one defense. But meanwhile, back over this side of the map, Bender are going to have to make a few more knights to deal with this by the looks of things. And I just love this. It's like a double forward, a double landing attempt. And it's just so awesome. These archers causing havoc in here. And actually, Bender unable to take gold at the moment, though he does have a bit more gold in the bank. This knight needs to be careful. He doesn't want to throw that away. He needs to get a couple more out. In fact, he's got the resources to do so. He's just not doing it at the moment. And Chris, where's the army control? Gonna run these archers under this town center. If Bender garrisons here as well, he could have massacred all of these units. But no, Bender gonna leave it a little bit late. And Chris gonna get back there doing good damage. And this knight will survive for now. More knights coming out for Bender. Meanwhile, Bender trying to micro over here. And I guess, you know, you can't blame him for not garrisoning over here. And you can't blame Chris for letting his army control go a bit lax over here, because he has got knights in his base. And Chris now pumping out those spears. Chris, though, is still feudal. He's still only on the one TC. He's still losing villagers back here, and this is a big problem. He can't upgrade to pikes. And he's not actually upgrading his spears at the moment. He's got no resources to upgrade them with. This could be a real problem. These three knights from Bender doing so much damage. And what, he made 5 in total, maybe 6, and he's killed so many villagers. And as long as he can kite these spears, he's going to keep killing villagers all day long. But Bender, back at home now with those 2 town centers, he can be comfortable in making more villagers. He can get his eco back on track much quicker, and provided that he can secure some gold again, he can continue that knight production and take out this army. But Bender with the mangonel, this is what he should have done in the last game. That mangonel production on the way up, and that is fantastic. That mangonel will destroy this army so quickly, and Bender at this moment in time, I think he has got this game in the bag at the moment. He has so won this game for now. Chris is so far from castle. This army will get destroyed incredibly quickly once this mangonel comes out from Bender now. If Chris isn't paying attention for 1 second, these archers will get taken down by the mangonel shot. And that's coming in. So I think Chris is going to have a tough time against this now. So far from the castle age. Well, the mangonel shot misses. He's going to go in with the knights, though, and hit his own units by the looks of things. Tower going up from Chris on this right side, but there's the mangonel shot he needs. One more shot, and this army is gone. It is so painful to watch. Chris losing everything now as that final mangonel shot comes in, and these forward villagers get taken down as well. Bender could just attack this tower and it will go down. Repairing the mangonel will be more than enough to keep it alive. And I think that's it for Chris on this landing attempt. Meanwhile, Chris has dealt with the knights from Bender, but he's lost so much. He's on 70 pop... What the heck? You're kidding me? Chris is on 70 population still. What's his population coming from? Chris has 17 miners, 12 lumberjacks, and 6 farmers. It must be coming from... His population must be in the galleys, surely. I mean, how many galleys has he got? He's got 15 warships at this moment in time. 9 infantry. Yeah, okay. So a lot of Chris's population is coming from military. 29 of his population is military. For Bender, I don't think anywhere near that amount is military. He's not got, well, he's got very little, in fact. But, I'm really confused by that. How has Chris managed to keep his population so high? It looked like he lost so many villagers. And, he has lost a lot of villagers. With 2 TCs, though, for Bender, I wouldn't be surprised if Bender really starts to pull ahead now. That villager from Bender there, nearly getting killed by his own mangonel. That was a bit close for comfort. And Bender now could retake that water control if he wanted to. In fact, he's adding in some fishing ships now for good measure. And that's a little bit risky because Crystal has a good amount of galleys here. But Bender, adding in the fishing ships, he doesn't care. I think a fire ship or, just upgrading to war galley and making some more of them would be very beneficial. But Bender at the moment retaking that gold now. Needs to clean up this forward still, though. Because these archers are still going to be a pain in the ass. Though he can defend very easily with the mangonel. And Chris still feudal. Chris is not up to the castle age still. Chris never added in any more fishing ships either. Which I find quite amusing. Or quite amazing, almost, as well. And still not up to the castle age. Whilst Bender has been up for so long. And, wow. Chris getting taken down on this wood camp over here. These villagers finally getting dealt with. No more buildings on the front for Chris now. And Gaia getting involved as well with that wolf. This villager going down. What? No, okay, never mind. Bender's just going to leave it. What the hell? Like, how did he even do that? Like, why did he even do that? Just, come on. That villager was so dead. But nah, never mind. It's fine. Chris, though, still causing a little bit of havoc, killing a couple of villagers off over here, but always going to end up losing out against the mangonel here if he's not paying attention. And, even with crossbows, it's difficult to out-micro a mangonel. With archers, it's even harder. I mean, 7 range versus 5, 4 plus 1 attack, it's not much. They get one shot by the mangonel as well. We'll see if he can do it. If he closes the gap, he might be able to do enough damage. But if Bender does repair the mangonel, then it's going to be quite easy to take down. Repair's coming in. And that's going to stay up for a while by the looks of things. He just needs to move out of the way so that he can take it down. And good micro by Chris. Going to get in there. But the mangonel shot is going to happen, and you can't delay the inevitable forever. Those archers getting taken down, the Mangonel surviving, and what, one villager lost for Bender there. Bender's score is massively in the lead at the moment, and for now, he's just building that eco up, not worrying too much about knights over at Chris's side. He knows Chris has got a ton of spears, so making the knights would be a little bit risky and probably not worth it too much. But Bender now starting that war galley production. Oh, he's got a few war galleys coming out. And of course, he's going to be looking to take down Chris's galleys and completely secure that water control once again, denying Chris the opportunity to land. And he'll deal with Chris's buildings on this right side as well. So, I mean, Bender should have this game in the bag unless he monumentally screws up. He has got this. But of course, Chris, not going to give up just yet. He's still playing on, and he's waiting for that Castle Age upgrade now. Double stables at the front. Looks like he's going to go for some knights as well, but I'm just waiting for Bender to start pushing out on the water now and taking down these docks, taking down these galleys from Chris. But yeah, still, Chris having to take that extra stone as well. Of course, he did take some stone for the towers at the front of Bender's base, but having to take more stone just to get your TCs is never so nice. And Chris now up to the Castle Age, making no more units from these archery ranges. So look at that wood and gold. 1,200 gold, 600 wood. He's got so much, and I'm wondering what he's going to spend it on. War galley upgrade coming out at the moment. Bodkin arrow as well, so we can start getting a little bit of a comeback perhaps on the water. And I'm surprised that he's not making more archers. I know he's been throwing them away to these this Mangonel, but if he actually just sticks them inside the archery ranges like that, makes 5 archers in each range, upgrades them to crossbow, he could easily take that Mangonel down, and he could then probably do a lot more damage to Bender. If he just saves his army up, it would work out. But hey ho, look at this. Chris coming out with a sneaky demo. Some fire ships on the way out as well. War galley is done, and I wonder if this sneaky demo is going to work out. Barbecue Turtman would love this. But uh-oh, Bender's going to go back, and that sneaky demo is not going to happen. But it is inside the dock. So if Chris baits him back, we could see it pop out and do a huge amount of damage. For now, though, Bender gonna go back, and I think he could easily win that fight should he commit. He is missing Bodkin arrow though, and he is just waiting for that research to come in. By the looks of it, turning back around now that Bodkin arrow has been done, and Bender now pushing right the way forward. There's the demo ship though, tucked away. And there's the GG from Chris. I don't think look at that. The knight's coming into his eco as well. Didn't even notice that one. Losing those spearmen. No upgrades on the spearmen still. And Bender just having enough knights there to clean a house. Very well played by Bender. I liked that game a lot. It was really nice. The fact that they both landed each other and both deleted their ships. But I think that because Bender had that Castle Age advantage, his eco was getting much further ahead. Because he had those knights out much sooner, he could deal with that forward from Chris as well. And I think Chris's mistake as well there was attacking too soon. Like I said, if he'd have just waited and massed up maybe 10 archers before attacking, then there was no way that Bender would have been able to attack with his villagers and kill as many archers as he did. And if if Chris went in, he could have denied Bender's gold very quickly, denied his wood completely, and then Bender wouldn't have been able to make that stable. He would have had to buy the wood, and then he would have no gold for knights. So that game could have been completely different had Chris just waited, I think, a little longer with those archers. Meanwhile, he was getting raided back at home himself, but that was a very good, game from Bender. So I liked that a lot from him. So there you go. That was a best of 3. Bender's going to take it 2-1, and we're going to go back.